Hollywood, California, a sprawling empty metropolis of smog, traffic, neurotic women, and mental insanity. Every year, millions of people flock to this place in hopes of living their dreams. Most of those dreams end up dead and in the gutter. Like Dionne Warwick sang, "And all the stars that never were are parking cars and pumping gas." One of those people living their dreams is director Damon Packard. He is commanding his first major motion picture for a studio. Here on the back lot of Universal Studios, Damon is trying hard to figure out what he's doing. He literally has no idea what movie it is he's making, or how to make his ideas come to life. Damon found himself suddenly thrust into this situation with a cast and crew at his command.
Well, it's really a peculiar situation. I find myself here with a group of people, a crew, a cast of real actors, people who I've always wanted to work with, but I don't know what we're, I don't have any idea, I don't know what we're doing.
Damon's confusion is shared by many of the cast members. Here, actor William Holden is trying hard to maintain his patience on the set.
I don't know where this so-called director came from, but this is the most ridiculous shoot I've ever been on. None of us have seen a script. None of us have the faintest clue what we're doing. None of us have ever heard of this guy.
In position, please, Phillips.
And frankly, I'm getting ready to leave.
For some odd reason, I just can't figure out what we're doing in this movie. I need to figure out the blocking. I need to figure out who's saying what, the dialogue. It's really terrific being here in 1973. I tell you, it's a nice feeling. Nobody has any cell phones. I haven't even mentioned that to anyone because no one would know what I'm talking about. No mobile devices, no computers. People are reading books. It's really something else. I didn't realize that they had video assist in 1973, but they do. We have it. We have video assist. Can you believe that? I had no idea it was around at this time. It's incredible.
40-year veteran of film and television actress Sylvia Sidney makes the best of the situation.
Well, I don't know what the hell we're doing, but frankly, I'm enjoying it. I can certainly think of worse ways to spend the day, and at least this gets me out of the house. This young man directing, well, I guess he's not that young. I don't know who the hell he is or where he came from, but he's terribly confused. But that's okay, I'm confused most of the time as well.
Actress Barbara Parkins from Valley of the Dolls and the Mephisto Waltz reflects on the situation.
This confused director is a very sleazy kind of man. I think he came from directing pornography or adult films. I really don't know. I don't know what any of us are doing here. It's like being lost in a dream.
Once more, please.
Let's set the whole street on fire.
Sometimes I think all of us are lost in our dreams. We wander alone in this strange labyrinth we call the world. And what awaits us on the other side is our real life.
John, Go back a few feet, and then...
The tension is growing daily, and it is all too obvious the showrunners are getting nervous with the situation. Noted actor and director John Huston is called in as an emergency replacement for Damon.
The head of the studio called me one day and asked if I might think of replacing this man as director of this film. Well, I don't even know what I'm replacing. There's no script. There's no concept. In fact, there's no rhyme or reason that I can see for any of this. I think someone should call up Rod Serling. This would make a good Twilight Zone episode.
It has to be, we have to be high enough so that we've got...
Oh my God! I know the stuntmen of this era were completely gung-ho, we'll do anything, so let's get some stunts going. I mean, I don't care what, we'll crash a car, we'll have a stuntman fly through the window,
I was on the phone with the head of production this morning, and he doesn't have any idea what's going on either. I would be happy to offer my services as an actor and perform if we knew what we were performing. I suppose the only thing to do now is make the best of it.
This will be like the last act of Hooper, the movie Hooper, which hasn't come out yet. I'm just going to take advantage of every resource we have. It'll be complete pandemonium.
When I direct, I don't do much directing anyway, and I often get the best results that way. So, I wish this man the best of luck with whatever this is. I don't think anyone knows.
You ready, Jim? Rehearsal, guys! All right,
this is just rehearsal. Ready? And...
Action. Now move.
Okay, bring everyone in. Bring all the drivers in.
I think we conjured something up, Joe. We opened up a portal into another world or something. This is incredible. I think I'm going to call this film Race with the Other Side. Larry Karaszewski suggested that title. I don't know, what do you think? Let's get the hell out of here before the fire department shows up.
After opening up a portal to a demonic hell, the crew can finally go home.
Let's get the hell out of here before the cops show up. Let's go home, guys.
All in a good day's work on the set of Race with the Other Side. Coming soon from Universal Pictures.